I blow my hair out with my blow dryer. It's oiled, as you can see, just by me touching it. I'm gonna do the Bantu knots. I'm actually gonna try something new. It's the Optimum Oil Therapy by Soft Sheen. If you can see it good. But it has micro oil technology, coconut oil, olive, avocado, and jojoba oil. It's pretty thick, you know. Shake it. So I want to try that for my Bantu knots. It actually does have bad ingredients. It has mineral oil and silicone and petroleum, garnier, fructis, and this is the pliable clay. I actually got this at the dollar store, and as you can see, it's really thick. Oh my god, the consistency is like you left your lotion, your body lotion, out for like months and let it dry out. That's how thick it is. It's really, really big. And I'm not gonna do them really small. I'm just gonna do them pretty big here. So let's get started. I'm gonna do them front to back so that you guys can see how I do them. I even have my spray bottle, which I don't know if I'll need depending on how watery this is. But I usually like my hair to be pretty much dry when I do it, so that only the wetness comes from the products, and it will set with this. So what I'll do is I'll just part my hair. Part it a good way down the middle, going horizontal. In the back, I'll tie back. So I'm gonna do a couple here for you guys just to see how I do. You can pretty much look up videos how people do theirs. So what I do is I usually use my finger just to part, and you see this space right here is pretty, it's actually pretty small for me. Actually, so I part like that and like that, so I'll do those two. I'll start with this one on the side. My hair's pretty much detangled. I'm just pulling through. I do have some Hair Veda's Almond Glaze. I'll be using a dab on each section. About that much, because my hair's already pretty much oily. But just to give it that good oily on the ends. Then I'm going to use this. Oh yeah, it's pretty wet. So yeah. So I get about a fingerful of that. And put that in there. Pretty good. And just depending on how my hair feels, if it feels wet enough to set, then I'll leave it. If not, which it doesn't really feel that wet, I'm going to give it a spritz on it. And yeah, that's good. So we got that in there. Add a little bit more, seems to be just absorbing into my hair. Let's see here. Okay, so I have pretty good time left. And then I'll use this, which is pretty much the key to it for me, to get that hold. So I use about that much. It actually does turn quite white. But that doesn't matter. This yellow stuff, this oil therapy, it is quite oily. I might not even need the Hair Veda. So, again, just grab a comb right on the end. Then I'll split it down the middle. Take this and twist it. I hope you guys can see that, but you know pretty much what a two-strand twist looks like. And I'll twist it all the way to the end. And, oh, it's quite shiny. I love it. I don't really want to like this oily stuff too much, but it's okay. Then I take it and I just wrap it around each other.
knots looks like that. A little Bantu knot.
See that? Just to secure it, I take a hairpin and I just stick it all through there. Usually when you're twisting your hair, a lot of people get a lot of product, you know, start oozing out of it. And mine is doing it too. It's just not white like it usually is. It's like oily, which is like a first for me. My hair's never oozed oily. Not that it's bad or anything, but I never usually use oil, which this is a good thing because, like I said, I want to incorporate more oil into my regimen. Make sure my hair is properly moisturized with the right oils. So again, looks like that. Okay, guys. It's going to take me about, I'll say 20 minutes or so to do the rest of my hair. So I'm going to finish and I'll be back when it's all done. I have 7 on this side and 7 on this side. Here's pretty much how they're looking. They look the same way in the back. They're not super tight. And as you can see, the parts aren't perfect. I did finger parts. It'll just be easier to cover up. So I'm just going to sleep with my satin bonnet on. I don't have it in here, but I'm just going to throw it on to sleep before I go to bed. Before I go out tomorrow, I'll just take them out and we'll see the results. Bye. Okay, hey YouTube. It's the next morning. It's the next afternoon, basically. I took out all my pins already. And I started taking out the back. They're not super springy like they are usually.
Unravel them. And then pull them apart. It actually feels, well, it feels dry. It feels really silky. Then I just do that. I don't know if you guys can see that. So I'll just go ahead and finish them off. So I just unravel them, separate them, and then fluff with my hand. I don't try to take my time. Like I said, my hair is going to go fro-y anyway, so it doesn't matter. Actually, they feel a little damp, and it's been about 12 hours. You see how that one did? It went a little fro-y because it's a little damp. I'm actually kind of mad about that. Yeah, you can tell from them being slightly damp, just even that little bit, pretty much the curl has already come out. And it's already frizzing to my regular fro, which is fine, but you know. So as much as I like this product, while I was doing my hair last night, how my hair was absorbing it and eating it, apparently I use way too much of the product, because even from dry hair, which my hair was, putting that product on, it doesn't really dry. I obviously put way too much product on. I should probably put about 2 finger scoops on each one, which apparently is too much product. So just gonna push it back like that. Alright. So I'm gonna fluff. Pictures will be up. Anyway, thanks for watching. She wearing her hair, she breaking them jeans. She talking that talk just like I like it. She keep it on and popping. Shorty keep it on and popping. Ooh, yeah. Shorty, the way you wearing that top got your boys all hot. Ain't no mistaken plan. Faking, you got me open and waiting.